Oh.
How's the nose?
It's hurting a little bit. I think maybe it's broken a little bit nasally, but the win is better.
How do you feel the fight went?
I thought it was good. You know, I was a little bit surprised. I thought we were going to go to the ground a little bit sooner or more, but I think it was good. I think I showed a lot of heart. And the experience to be three rounds standing up is just being in there. You know, I have a lot of submissions, fast submissions, like first round. So I'm really happy to be able to show like my cardio was good. And even with a broken nose, I can get it in the third round.
When that nose, the injury to your nose did happen, that's the first time you've had something like that. That's the first time you've had something like that happen to you in a fight, right?
Yeah.
So what was that experience like? Did you freak out? Did you think, oh, it's finally happening? What was going through your mind?
Yeah, I never actually really got even a lot of blood on a fight before. So when I got it, it didn't hurt too bad. I just heard the sound. But when I started to saw a lot of blood, I thought, okay, maybe it's a cut. You know, I'm praying it's a cut. And then on the second on the corner, I asked my coach, oh, is it broken? You think? He said, no, it's okay. It's just a cut. And I said, like, okay, I know my coach, and it's probably broken.
Did you, when it went to the judges, were you confident? Did you think you had done enough to win?
Yeah, I thought I won. I thought it was two for me and one for her. And I thought, like, man, I broke my nose, and I tried to come back the third round, so I hope they give to me.
Congratulations. I'm sorry about the nose.
Oh, that's good. Thank you. Okay.
Hello. Mackenzie, so this is obviously now 3-0 for 2020. You rebounded from the first loss of your career last year. I mean, just can you discuss overall what you really focused on that really just continued this run for you? Because obviously, you know, we know about the change in camp and everything. So just how did you stay focused to just continue this development in 2020?
I think the pandemic, you know, the pandemic helped a lot because you stay at home and you can't travel, you can't do anything. So staying at home and have nothing to do, it's kept me, okay, let's go train. And then also being at the Ruka gym, you see like Bisping, Chito Vera, you see Luke Rockhold, you see all these champions in all the time. And that just pushes you to be there too. You know, I see Chito's in the gym. I said, okay, I got to go too. You know, I need to do what they're doing because I want to be like them, you know, champion. And the seeing my evolution in my striking really made me more and more determined. So I said, okay, when you see you're getting better, you want to keep going and keep going. So it was always fun to be at the academy and training and everything. It wasn't like, oh. I think before my old gym was always a battle just to go to the gym, you know, because I had to fight mentally my coach, mentally myself. And at the gym, the Ruka gym is just like happy to be there and free, and it's really nice. And when you see the good result, I stayed 1 year off, you know, being pregnant. So I knew I needed to catch up with the girls that had kind of passed me. And now I definitely feel like I'm caught up, and I'm trying to really put my spot in the top 10 and become a title contender.
Just for the record, when you say your old team, are you talking about Black House or the Lab?
Both. Okay. Black House and more.
So you talked about you're trying to get a submission of the year. At what point did you forget about that and just decide you want to throw hands tonight?
You know, I won a submission of the year, but I thought, hey, maybe we can have knockout of the year. And, you know, I really just been training so much my striking. You know, I went for some takedowns, but I kind of was feeling a little bit chasing her. So I was kind of going into takedowns far. So I started to feel my hands landing more than my entrance to the takedown. So I said, okay, I think this fight's going to be a little bit more stand up. And I started to feel my jab hitting her. And on the third round, I felt like kind of knocked her a little bit. Just, I'm anxious, you know, I get really excited. And instead of being calm and seeing the opening, I just kind of went on top of her. And then we got into a clinch and she can breathe and things like that. So I really enjoyed getting the experience of having three rounds of stand up and kind of show people like, hey, if my jiu-jitsu doesn't work, I can stand up too.
My final question, there's a lot of talk sometimes with the female divisions, the next Ronda Rousey. And when you came to the UFC, you got a lot of attention. People were excited, you're undefeated, everything. I guess when you have a lot of expectations like that, how do you tune it out so you can just grow and develop as a fighter at your own pace? Because obviously it's, you know, people want to compare you, but you're just trying to have your own career.
Yeah, I think my, that kind of started when I started getting my knockouts, like not my knockout, but with Amanda Cooper, I knocked down and then the submission, and I started kind of building my own style. You know, Ronda, she has a great style, you know, aggressive and everything, but I think when I start to get like the leg locks and I really saw like, okay, I have something different, really different, you know, which is the jiu-jitsu, these leg locks from the bottom, you know, where people think you're losing and doing kind of breaking records. And I kind of just set my goal on breaking records, you know. I said, okay, Ronda broke records, you know, but I'm going to break more records, you know. So I'm just focused on that, like one straight line, you know, the horse, how it has the thing, that's what I have. And it's a pleasure for me that everyone was saying that, you know, but it was kind of pretty easy for me to focus on me and have my goal and try to be a legend.
Thank you, Mackenzie. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Did you see the main event?
I was hoping fight of the night, but man, those guys, they really put so much heart and it was a great fight. It was awesome.
Mackenzie.
Oi.
Tudo bom?
Uh-huh.
Primeiro, eu queria saber se você já tinha passado por uma experiência assim, o nariz sangrando, de repente em treino, isso foi uma surpresa, e como foi lidar com esse momento?
É, foi muito diferente, nunca passei por isso. É, sabia que um dia ia acontecer, mas ainda que eu sempre achava que meu nariz tinha mais possibilidade de quebrar, porque eu tenho esse osso um pouco maior, entendeu? Então, eu sempre pensei, ah, se um dia quebrar na luta, talvez aproveita e faz um plástico também, entendeu? Mas eu fiquei surpresa realmente de ter acontecido com a Virna, entendeu? Que é do jiu-jitsu, eu não esperava a trocação dela ser uma luta tão equilibrada assim. Eu estava confiante na minha trocação, mas eu gostei, assim, não doeu tanto, entendeu? Achei que era um corte só, depois eu comecei a sentir a minha respiração, mas eu gostei de ver que no terceiro round eu consegui manter minha força, manter a pressão, manter tudo que eu precisava para realmente deixar claro que a vitória era minha.
O nariz quebrou?
Eles falam que sim, mas vão esperar desinchar para confirmar, mas acredito em si.
Tá, ok. A luta foi bastante travada em pé, disputada em pé. Isso mostra uma evolução grande. Você já tinha mencionado antes da luta que fez muito sparring lá com o Jason Parrillo, né? Era isso que você queria? Você tinha essa vontade de mostrar a sua evolução em pé também? E como você se avalia na trocação agora, nesse nível? Agora, provavelmente, você vai entrar no top 10.
Sim, eu queria ficar aí trocando, eu queria machucar ela em pé, para depois levar para o chão, para ser um pouco mais fácil, né? Eu achava ela ia ser forte no chão, então queria dar esse trabalho e mostrar que, eu acho que para top 10, né, tem que mostrar que você é versátil, né? Você é bom em tudo. Eu acho que eu mostrei isso. Lógico, tem muito para melhorar, porque a Virna, ela, ponto fraco dela é a trocação, ela não é a melhor trocadora da categoria, entendeu? Mas eu acho que eu mostrei que eu posso ser perigosa assim na trocação, só que eu achei que eu fiquei um pouco empolgada às vezes, entendeu? Eu ficava bem com o meu jab, com o meu direto, mas às vezes eu mandava aquelas bombas sem asa, entendeu? Que acho que é um hábito meu. Mas eu estou 4 meses com o coach Parrillo, já vi uma evolução enorme e eu tenho certeza que 2021 vai ser mais evolução ainda e que já vou estar preparada para a luta para aquela cinturão.
Maravilha. Minha última pergunta, então. Você entrando no top 10, possivelmente, o que você imagina para 2021? Que tipo de desafio você gostaria a seguir?
Desafios? 2021?
Qual o desafio que você gostaria a seguir?
Ah, eu acho que lutar com alguém mais ranqueado que eu, entendeu? Eu nunca lutei com alguém mais ranqueado que eu. Então, esse vai ser meu primeiro foco e lutar mais vezes possível. Entre esse critério de alguém que realmente vai fazer uma mudança no meu ranking e me botar mais perto do cinturão. Eu vou estar treinando bastante minha trocação, porque o Coach Parílio mora na Califórnia, né? Academia que eu treino todo dia. E eu vou estudar, eu vou voltar, eu vou ver minha luta, estudo bastante, estudo todas as adversárias que tem no top 10. Eu acho que tem muitas meninas que vão lutar entre elas, então eu estou ansiosa para saber qual oportunidade que vai aparecer para mim, quem vai estar disponível para lutar comigo, como é que vai ser, entendeu? Mas é lutar com alguém que vai me puxar e eu poder mostrar ou trocação, ou chão, ou o que for. Mas se não ganhar finalização do ano esse ano, pode ser que 2021 eu vou atrás disso também. Yeah. Todas.